How's it going, guys? James96 here back with another episode on the Kplex SMP server. Yes, welcome back, guys, to another episode. It's been a little while since the last one, I think. I don't think it's been too long, but it's been a little while. And by the way, if you think my voice sounds slightly different, it's because I've just woken up to record this. I'm out all day today, so I need to get this recording done nice and early. It was meant to be out yesterday, but because of things taking longer, basically, than they should. We are here today instead, but that's okay because we're going to get some stuff shown off today because I've been busy, guys. I've been busy working on main spawn, not this spawn. So yeah, I want to basically just show you guys what I've been up to, and then we'll see how much time we've got left and work from there. So this is spawn town, just to clarify, and then there's the spawn. I've shown most of this off in live streams. I can't remember if I've done it in a video or not off the top of my head, but basically we've got spawn town, which is obviously this area here. I think I have shown this in a video, and then through this magic portal we have got spawn. So this is out at 10,000 by 10,000, so pretty far out, and basically out here is where all our automatic farms are. And as you can see, I've been busy since last time. Let me just go through everything sort of step by step. So let's quickly hop back through. The first thing that you may have seen is this device right here. Now what this does, have we got anything left in it? Yes, good. 13. So what this device does is this is a, it's a device which isn't actually doing anything yet, but it will be doing something in the future. And basically what it's going to do is it's like a 5-minute timer for sending items through. So basically what this does is, without trying to collect the block, underneath here is a pressure plate, and this dropper shoots an item onto it. That item will stay there for 5 minutes, and then obviously it will despawn. And when it despawns, another item gets placed there. And at the same time, every time an item gets shot out of that dropper, an item gets shot out of that dropper, which goes through the portal. And now the reason that I've done that is because this 5-minute timer, it will only be 5 minutes of time that these chunks are loaded. Because what happens in Minecraft is, obviously, when you unload chunks, unless they're the spawn chunks, if you unload regular chunks, then the item despawn time doesn't go down whilst the item isn't being loaded effectively. So you can basically have this, so it's a timer of 5 minutes whilst this area is active, and then as you can see, the 5 minutes ran out, so an item disappeared and the new item got shot out there. And basically that is how that works, and it works really nicely. So I can actually pretty accurately time how long people have been in spawn over the last couple of days since I built this. So I put 32 items in, there's 12 left. So if I just get my calculator out, if I do 32 minus 12 equals 20 times by 5, so people have been in spawn town for 100 minutes over the course of the last couple of days. So hopefully that puts it into a bit of perspective. Anyway, let's move on to the main thing that I've been working on. So the main thing is this over here. I've done quite a lot of redesigning since, and as you can see, this is where the item lands. It lands just there. Eventually it will go into, it will be worked out into this system here, but for the moment it's like that. Anyway, so as you can see, I've done quite a lot of work over at spawn here. This is all my doing. Other people have been working on spawn town, getting that close to finishing. I decided I was a bit bored of building the wall, so I decided to get started on these projects over here. So basically what we have done, I think I've already showed off these pumpkin and melon farms. I've definitely done them in a live stream, but me and Dan worked these out basically based on, you want the rails as slow as possible, and these blast miners will just harvest up a bunch of pumpkins and melons, which just sit on the top, and then they pop off and disappear. The main thing that I've been working on is this here. This is a storage area on the spawn side. So what will happen is, when these automatic farms are running, but no one is in the spawn town. Right, this is going to get confusing. When these farms, Let's try that one more time. These farms are going to be running all the time because they're automatic farms in the spawn chunks, which is great. However, if we just sent all of those items through the portal and there was no one in the spawn town, those items would just build up because they don't load the chunks when they teleport. That's just something to do with the teleport command that we've got for this portal. So the items would just sit on the floor, which means if you sent through tons of items before someone went to the spawn chunks, basically as soon as someone did go there, there'd just be a massive crash, which we don't want. So what we've done is we've created some storage on this side, and then we've created a management system for how to send the items through. And that's what I'm going to be showing off for you now, and basically explaining what I've done and how I've done it. So we should probably start from the beginning. So let's take this farm, for example. This farm is pumpkins and melons. It's actually the only farm that I've got running at the moment because I haven't put the cobblestone generator back. But as you can see, blast mine, it goes underneath, it blows up some of the pumpkins and melons. You'll then see this pumpkin gets picked up in a second. Okay. And then when it next comes around, it gets dropped off in this hopper here, as you'll see now. Yep, see, it went to 2, then to 1. And then basically what happens is these all feed through, and they're actually still being filtered through from this. This has been shooting off for like, I think it's been like 5 or 6 hours. I started this timer before I went to sleep last night. So actually it's probably even longer than that, than like 7 or 8 hours this has been firing. It still hasn't got through all the backlog. But yeah, basically it filters through. We've got a filter on each of these. This one filters just for melons, this one filters just for pumpkins. The reason I have to do that is so that the redstone torch that has to be in that doesn't get taken out. And then basically what happens is they go through, and this is a dropper which is shooting the items down. And then what it's doing from there is the items, I've got a tube which goes all the way down to the bottom of the map. Now the reason that we go all the way down to the bottom of the map is because what I want to happen is as we add more module or more farms, I want it to be nice and easy to hook up to this main item elevator we've got at the back. So the easiest way to do that, I decided, was to put the item elevator right at the bottom of the world. Because then you don't have to worry about, oh, I built this farm lower than all the others, so I have to make a mini item elevator to bring it up so that it can go into the main item elevator. If we put the main item elevator right at the bottom of the world, then that way all of your outputs you can just shoot straight down. Bit of effect there. All of your items you can shoot straight down from wherever they start, and then just link them up via water channels. So let's show that off quickly. Let's sleep as well, because I don't want too many hostile mobs around. This area isn't very safe at the moment. I've even put some signs up saying spawn areas are work in progress, please be careful. Also please don't take from the chest lying around. Okay, so to show off, I think my little drop hole was down here, because this is actually using something which is meant to be for a module, but it's been blocked off. So I assume it will get moved at some point, but I'm not sure. Anyway, let's go down and have a look at it. So this goes right down to on top of the bedrock box. So underneath here is all the commands for every single module that we've got installed. And then here, as you'll see a constant flow for the moment of items going down from the melon farm. And what they're doing is they're then flowing along. And then I can just take these out to show. So this one? No, too far. Okay, so as you can see, it's then a bulk standard item elevator, which just shoots them all up to the surface. And then the idea is that if, say, I have another farm which starts in this direction, I can just grab my water bucket and link it in to this stream here, and then they'll all get fired up together, no matter what the item is. And then eventually there'll be a sort of maze of water channels down the bottom here, which could be quite cool in itself. And hopefully it will work better that way. Hopefully. It does mean if you build a farm up on the surface, you've got to make one of these one wide tunnels all the way down for the items to get a shot through, but really I don't think that's a major thing. It doesn't take a lot of durability, and as long as you're careful you can do it pretty safely. Alright, let's get up on the surface. Okay, so what happens is the items get shot up. They then go through to this item elevator around the back here. And what that is doing is it's firing. It's obviously just an item elevator. I'm sure I've shown these on my channel before. So basically, it's just a solid slab of material. And I actually dug all the way down in a 3x3 shape to make sure it was all cobblestone so people knew not to break it, hopefully. Hopefully being the key word there. But as you can see, it then shoots up to the surface and you'll see they just randomly appear in the water channel. I'm having no problems with the items disappearing or anything, which is really nice. So they then shoot into here and then they go into this mammoth item sorter. So we should probably hop back around to the front here. So as you can see, what we've got is we've got an item sorter, which sorts different items into different chests. And how this works is you've got these double chests all linked together, these three. So you've got double chest and a hopper, which points into the double chest. That is then drained by this hopper here into that chest, which is drained by this hopper here into that chest, which is then drained by the hopper into the dropper there. Hopefully that all made sense. And then you've got that as a tileable pattern. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 modules effectively. So 6 dispensers, 6 lots of storage. So hopefully that all makes sense to you. But basically, you designate your storage based on groups of 3. So this 3 is going to be for iron when we set up an iron farm, which I'm going to have to do very soon if you look at the amount of hoppers I'm burning through. Pumpkins, melons, and sugarcane go in this one. So you'll see some melons have got in here. The pumpkins I don't think have been shot through yet. I don't think. From what I can tell, they just are probably just sitting in the dispense somewhere. I don't know where. There you go. So they are not going to go until right at the end now. But if I, for example, move like that. Kind of shot myself in the foot there. How am I going to get that back? Oh, I got one of them in. Yeah, we got them both in. Okay, cool. So, now you'll, in a sec, see some pumpkins come through. We'll check that in a sec. But basically, yeah, how this works is these three items, the sugarcane, melons, and pumpkins, have a shared storage. So, it will probably be that we get a ton of melons in this area and not as many sugarcane or pumpkins. But, you know, that's just how it works. It's only going to go 3 chests worth. 3 double chests worth. And then after that, it was just going to overflow, so I'm not too worried. And I tried to group the items together in a smart way. So obviously, I only put sugarcane pumpkins I put together because they're linked together, basically, by the way they're shot out. Although I could do it separately, but it saves me a dropper clock to do that. And sugarcane, they're all going to be producing fairly similarly anyway, I think, once we get a decent enough sugarcane farm. These we've linked together because they're all going to be going at the same rate. Hopefully they're going to be like a villager system. The chicken, the feathers, and cactus was just an odd one, but they're all linked there. And then we've got stone, stone, and cobblestone, which are all linked together as well. And the reason that is stone is because there's not actually an item sorter behind that one, which I'll show in a sec. And then we've got these three on the end, which is just the overflow chest, which I shouldn't see anything in. A single melon, okay. So it looks like a single melon went through a bit too quick through the system. And it ends up in the overflow chest, which isn't a major issue at all. I'm not really worried if a single melon out of the several stacks that have gone through so far. And as you can see, the pumpkins are starting to come in now. And you'll see also that there's nothing currently in the dropper or hopper. I'll show you why in a second. And then we've got this nice little faceplate here with glass. Hopefully I'm explaining this well, by the way. We've got this nice little faceplate here with the glass. This is actually functional as well, because when the dropper fires the item out, it sometimes fires further than 2 blocks. So we use glass panes, because then it doesn't go right up against the wall, which could end up it glitching into the wall if I'm very unlucky. With the glass panes, it's just going to hit it and drop into kind of the center of this second block here, and then it funnels down and through and goes through this portal into the spawn chunks, which we haven't wiped out yet, which is part of the reason why there's nothing in the hopper and the dropper at the moment. Anyway, let's go around the back and try and show off the circuitry that we've got going on. There's no easy way round here either at the moment, which is slightly annoying. But I'm sure we can show it off nonetheless. So if we go up, up, and up here, then what we're looking at here is the full system. So like I said, items funnel in from here, and they go along this line. This line is just item filters. So all I've done is used a filler block here, which is just any block which you name to something so that you know that it's not going to go through the system, because you don't want it to suddenly appear in your system, basically. And then what we need to look at is this hopper, for example. So then the first 41 items will stay in here. This is basically your filter being set up. So this is the item it will accept. It won't accept any other item. And then if we look at the pumpkins, you'll see every time it goes above, it goes back down to 41, and 41 is where it will rest. I'm just going to chuck those back in because I don't want those. And how that works is just from this item sorter back here. So you've got a two strong pulse, and then you'll see the one which is pumpkins is this line, I imagine. Yeah, because every time it goes above 41, it goes that extra pulse strength, which you could see because this redstone is flashing. It's not complete, it's not really obvious, but it's flashing. And that then gets shot into a repeater, which then fires off a torch, which is linked to this hopper here. So basically what that does is that powers and unpowers the hopper, allowing items to go through. It's not that hopper, it's actually the one below. Let me try and get back. We really need some ender pearls. I think we're meant to be fighting the end dragon soon, but we really need ender pearls to be able to get around. I'm starting to notice it now that I do these kind of build things, build style stuff, especially with redstone, because it's always a nightmare to get through. But yeah, it basically links to that hopper below, which I can't actually access, which just points into the chest. So the clever thing about how I've done it is you can actually filter three items into a single system, because obviously you can point one of the sorters into a hopper, one of the sorters into a chest, and one of the sorters into the other side of the chest, and it's completely tileable. And you may be looking at this mesh of wires thinking, how come none of them overlap? Well, basically what happens is, because the... Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Hopefully I didn't break anything. Because you only want the... Because the signal strength can only get to a maximum of three long, and that's because that's the maximum number of items you can get in. If you had a 64 stack of pumpkins in here, and these four filler blocks, then the signal strength would only be three long. So as you can see, 1, 2, 3 will trigger this one, but it's never 4 to be able to trigger this one, or 4 to be able to trigger this one. So you're always safe, basically. And that also protects against overflow, because you can't get to the point where the system overflows and starts triggering other lines, because there can only be a maximum of 64 pumpkins in there. It won't start removing the filler blocks. They'll never get removed. So that is completely safe, which is awesome. So yeah, that happens. So that they get filtered in to the system. And then I'm going to go around and sleep in a bed so that I can show things off without being attacked. I did have a couple of instances with creepers, which was rather gutting, really. Never too much damage, and luckily never anything to like the hopper sorting system, but just some like water breaking some redstone. It's really annoying at the same time. So yeah, let's go round and show off the back. Oh. And let's eat this all up. I'm eating melons at the moment just because we've got a lot of them. So someone's got to do it, right? It's kind of silly having as many as we do already. I think it's more than most people are going to eat in a long time. But anyway, they kind of sort through. And then down the bottom here, we've got this tiled dropper clock. So obviously how this works is I can put, say, a cobblestone in here, and it'll just get fired off. You guys all know how dropper clocks work. We were showing them off just earlier in the episode. So basically, it was quite a bit of an issue to tile this because obviously you've only got basically a footprint of 3 wide, and then I've kept it to 1, 2, 3 deep. So it's actually a 3 by 3 area that I've got this in. So it's kind of complicated, but it's not too bad. So you've got this comparator here, which is testing for if there's any items in the dropper. That shoots immediately into a repeater, basically just to keep the signal strength. That then shoots into this block, which powers this redstone line through the block, which is really useful. That saved me some space, which then fires this, and then this powers the block, which then powers that dropper because of that, and shoots out the item. The redstone power also gets taken from this block underneath, shoots a repeater into the block under this piece of redstone here, which then powers that piece of redstone, which then completes the circuit, so it will then keep flashing on and off. So that's pretty complicated, and that is a tileable design. I actually had another tileable design which was slightly easier, but then I put these redstone torches on top, which meant I had to have a clear gap between them, basically to stop them fiddling with the circuit and breaking it. So yeah, it was a bit of a struggle, but I worked out a really nice system, and as you can see, there's actually points where the redstone touches, but luckily with some repeaters nothing happens. Like this point here, there's redstone connecting a hopper, a repeater and a comparator, but nothing happens because of the fact that the repeater doesn't take an input from the side. So I think that's really clever, actually. I'm very happy with that little piece of design. And then finally, to wrap up, we've got these redstone torches underneath, which currently don't do anything, they just hold the items here. But what we're gonna have happen is the redstone torches at the moment, they basically prevent one of the hoppers from doing anything, which is this hopper right here. So if I put an item in it, it's not going to get pushed through at the moment because the hopper is locked. That is going to be how we control how many items go through the portal into spawn. So what's going to happen is, if you remember our clock, which I showed at the beginning of the episode, this clock here, which fires items through to spawn. So once the item arrives, what I want to happen is there'll be a hopper which receives the item and then fires it immediately out onto a pressure plate. Now, whilst it's on the pressure plate, I want those torches to turn off and as many items to get fired out as possible, which will then go through to spawn. And the logic of that is that for five, as soon as someone enters the spawn chunks, you want items to be starting to send spawn town chunks, you want items to start being sent through because then they can be processed. So putting on a 5 minute timer minimizes the damage that could be caused if someone leaves town before the 5 minutes is up, because then it's not just constantly sending items through and it will keep backing up in here. So that's basically how that's going to work. So roughly in 5 minutes, it gets each drop, it gets through about 11 to 12 stacks of items. So that's about 4,800 max items that would go through in 5 minutes, which is great for getting items through to the other side and spawn town. But you need to make sure it's not any more than that, because otherwise you're gonna crash the server. But I think our server can take it, even if you do get occasionally that big spike because someone's left just after a 5 minute time starts. The worst is gonna be the people that kind of are hopping around, so they go into spawn town for a second just to grab something and then leave, which is fine, but it's gonna possibly trigger it. But again, it's not just gonna happen every time someone loads the spawn chunks, because that item on a pressure plate in spawn is gonna stay on there until someone's been in spawn town for 5 minutes. So you're not gonna get any more than those 4,800 items being sent through before they've been processed, basically. So that works quite well. But anyway, that pretty much sums up all of the work I've been doing. It's been a lot of work. I know this has been a very talky episode, and I do apologize for that. But this is quite a complicated system, and I thought you guys would be interested in seeing what I've been doing. Next time, I'm sure we'll be working on something else. I may also be in a point where I can fire this up and show you guys it in action. Unfortunately, it's not quite at that stage yet because of the fact that there's no storage capabilities on the other side to be able to hold the items, and we also need to set up that little timer thing that I told you about, which will take like 5 minutes to set up. but still, got to be done. Anyway, guys, that episode was something slightly different, so if you enjoyed it, then please let me know. But if you'd prefer one with a few more different projects going on, which is kind of what I normally try and do, then also let me know. I think there's going to be more episodes coming out this week, though, so I don't mind too much that this one is more of a talking explanation episode, because it was quite a complicated thing that we have going on here. Anyway, guys, if you enjoyed the episode, then please leave a like, and if you haven't already, then please subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.